Lecture video in which we're going to do a fine-tuning of a large language model. We're going to be using a parameter efficient fine-tuning method that's called LoRA. It stands for low rank adaptation. How that exactly works in the background, you can find information on that on the internet. In this video, we're going to go step by step through the lines of code you need to execute to perform a LoRA fine-tuning. And the code is on my GitHub. The link is in the description below. And we're just going to go through it line by line and see how it works on an example. So in this first cell here that I'm executing, I'm installing a couple of dependencies. Usually that takes a while. I've pre-installed them, so this should be quick. But you see here, I'm going to upgrade my pip. And then there's the various method, the various packages we need to install, one of them being PEFT for parameter efficient fine tuning. That's also what we're going to be using. I'm going to import all these dependencies, so this should run smooth. And we're going to import a model from Hugging Face. So on Hugging Face, you'll find a lot of models that you can download and use. Licenses are included, so you have to check that out, how you can use them. I'm going to be using this model here, which is for code generation. And by executing these lines, it will actually download the model locally. I've done that before, so I've kind of have a cache in my system. It goes a little bit quicker. It also comes with a tokenizer. So that is something that will tokenize your input for the model. And if we just want to execute this model and run an inference, I'd have an input text, for example. This is for code generation, so I'm just going to give it this signature line, write me a hello world, so to say. And then by executing the tokenization and then the generation and then printing the output, I'm going to get exactly that output. So it writes me the very simple hello world method, right? Just as you would expect. And now I want to fine-tune this model. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set it up. So there's a lot of hyperparameters you can consider. One of the important ones are, for example, the learning rate, how fast it should learn, and you know, drop-off rates for normalizations. And so all that plays a role, so you can tune these as needed. This set should work quite well on most standard cases, so I have that up here. And then on the LoRA, how it works, it actually acts on particular layers in the model, and particularly the linear layers. So what I'm going to do here is I have this little function that just identifies the linear layers in the existing model. When I run it, it actually then also prints me out what are these layers. These layers have this identifier here, and these are our target modules. This is what the LoRA is going to tune on, and that's then actually what I'm configuring here, the LoRA config. So that is a class in the PEFT module. I give it the hyperparameters and the target modules, and once I have that configuration, I can then call another function in the PFT package in which I pass in the model as well as the fine-tuning configuration, and now I have a model that I can fine-tune. Now with it, of course, also we had that already, but this is the tokenizer again. And now I need data to train on. And what I thought would be an interesting example that can be quickly done is to, I'm just going to generate a lot of gibberish, and I want this model actually to unlearn coding, in particular this hello world example. So what I'm generating here is random letters, and 100 of them right after the hello world signature line. So if I'm successful with my fine tuning, this model should afterwards no longer be able to write this hello world function, but instead spit out a random number string. Now again, there is no practical use case for this kind of fine-tuning. This is really for the demonstration of the model. In the real world, you would have some example of very specific data that you want your model to reproduce after the fine tuning. But I don't have that here. I'm just going to generate some you know, data that will clearly demonstrate that I'm successful with my fine tuning if I do that. So this is just for demo purposes. I have to prepare the data set a little bit. These lines do that. They have to go in a certain signature here in order to be part of that data set. So these three lines do that. And again, the code you'll find on my GitHub to get familiar with. Then I'm configuring the training as arguments. A lot of the hyperparameter goes in here. There is also something that will show you how often will it actually log and show some results. So we'll see that ongoing when it's training. And there's also checkpointing, where it should store the checkpoints. So if I just configure that, that will be really quick. I have then the trainer and tokenized dataset is not defined. Let me see that here. I didn't run this. Okay, good. Then I'm going to run this here. And now it's all good. Okay, so and then I can start the training. And I'm just going to kick that off. We'll see what happens. And I have a number of epochs and a certain length of a data set. And now every 50 steps, it will print out this training loss. And you see the trainer's loss is decreasing. I always find it gratifying to see that, right? Like even after tuning so many models or training machine learning models, there's just this very gratifying feeling about seeing training loss declining over time. That means the training is working. And we'll see, this will go up to step 900. So we're about halfway through. The number is still declining. It looks like something is definitely happening. And once it has completed its fine tuning, what we can do is then run an inference. So I'm gonna run the entire, or like the exact same example again, right? Hello world, and then see what it comes up with. And if the fine tuning was successful, which right now there is no reason to believe that it wouldn't be, but if it's successful, we expect that it will no longer write the actual code that will give you the hello world. It will write these random letters that we used in the training set. So it is completed. It ran to all the way to step 900. I'm going to execute this. And now we're going to see, oh, exactly that, right? So this was our input, hello world. And there is all these random lines of letters. So it no longer is a at least for this particular function, no longer is a good model for code generation after this fine tuning. So I hope you found this useful. This code is available to you on my GitHub. You can use it to fine tune your models. And yeah, use it responsibly, of course. And if you liked it, I hope I'll see you in one of the next lecture videos. Thanks for watching.